Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is almost a cube. And as you can already hear from its name, it is almost a cube, but it's not a real cube. If we look at this part, it looks like we are having a 5x5 Rubik's cube. But when we look here, it looks more like a 4x4 Rubik's cube with middle part. And if we look all the way at the bottom, we even have only 3 layers. And the way that this puzzle works is that you can rotate 2 of the layers like this. And then here we can, for instance, rotate that layer. And of course, it's a jumbling puzzle. So now this rotation is blocked, but we can easily move things around and then free these rotation layers. So when we look at the geometry of this puzzle, you will find that it's fairly similar to the fenced cube. Fenced cube is like the equivalent of a 3x3 Rubik's cube, and the almost a cube a bit like a 5x5. But you see, it has similar properties with one exception, and this is something that Melinda Green will really like. That is, when squeezing these parts together, there was not enough space to make both layers move. So here, this layer can rotate, but this layer, there was not room enough. So the solution, the result, is a puzzle that has no symmetry. So it has no mirror symmetry because of this, but it also has no rotational symmetry. So no symmetry at all. Very interesting. There's a question that I have to you about the geometry of this puzzle, and that is the puzzle quasi-doctrinaire? Thank you for watching.